clicking on this video, you're probably skeptical about the title. Really? I'll fail if I don't do this? And you're right to be doubtful, but I'm not clickbaiting you here. You can make games without doing this, but you'll never succeed as a game dev. I'm talking about getting more efficient. It sounds a little harsh, like you've got to ruthlessly cut corners to succeed in the biz, but it doesn't have to be that way. As game devs, we're already naturally geared towards getting more efficient. When we're in the middle of a tedious manual process, we start thinking about how to automate it. I'm not talking about ruining the fun of game dev, just skipping the boring parts. And of course, getting more efficient is not only necessary, but also enjoyable, even if it takes a bit of effort. The more wasted time you cut out, the more time you have to spend on programming, art, music, or whatever tickles your fancy the most. This also helps you avoid burnout, since you have more time to relax and plan out your schedule. So in this video, I'll discuss some of the most important techniques you can use to boost your efficiency. The first tip is, I think, the most essential one. Just be conscious about getting more efficient. You don't literally have to start each day by thinking about it, just try to be aware of what you could do to speed things up. As I already mentioned, our mind tends to wander there when we're in the middle of a boring process, like manually renaming a bunch of files. But even when you're in a normal part of your routine, your brain should be geared towards efficiency. Think about it like occasionally trying a new route to work to see if it's faster. Of course, not every idea will pan out, but sometimes you'll figure out a way to make your everyday work just a little bit more efficient. One thing that helped for me in the past few months was creating monthly and daily to-do lists. I tried this before while developing Breezy, but it was just too much effort to maintain. Now though, I use Obsidian as my main note-taking tool, which has a built-in daily note feature. It helps me organize my schedule without taking too much time away from my usual work, and it's definitely helped these videos come out on time. Once again, you might get skeptical here, but don't worry. I'm not trying to ruin your fun. You don't have to quit playing video games with your friends or listening to music. For this tip, I'm just talking about kicking habits that waste time without any benefit. A big one, especially for me, is Twitter. I joined the website in summer 2023 in order to market Breezy, and every few days I would post a little joke or development update. Some of these would be kind of successful, but the vast majority wouldn't be seen at all. And on my end, I would end up scrolling my feed for up to 30 minutes each day, even though the content on there was mind-numbing at best. The last straw was when I did a YouTube community poll asking if any of my fans had interacted with my Twitter account, and unsurprisingly, nobody had. So I decided to make one final post before logging out and deleting the app off my phone. I still haven't quit all social media, and I don't plan to. Reddit and YouTube still give me plenty of enjoyable content. Here's another example that applies for me. I realized a few years ago that I can't listen to music while I work. If it's really simple stuff, like adding decorations to levels in Breezy, it's not a problem. But if I'm studying, trying to get some serious game dev work done, or doing my actual work for actual money, I can't have music playing in the background. I guess my brain can't handle it because I can't focus or enjoy the music, and I usually just end up with a headache. So once again, don't remove the habits that bring you joy, just the ones that take away time without giving anything in return. My last tip is a bit more specific to game dev stuff. Improve your tools by whatever means necessary, whether that means tweaking some settings or replacing them entirely. If you're just starting out with a new tool, don't be afraid to try out alternatives. Give each one a fair chance, of course, but know when to move on. For example, as I mentioned in my last video, I switched my music making software a lot early on, from OrgMaker to Beatbox to GarageBand to LMMS to OpenMPT. But once you found a tool you like, explore different ways to customize it. Some applications are admittedly better at this than others. The shining stars are usually IDEs, which offer near infinite customizations through custom themes and plugins. On the other hand, a game engine like Unity takes a lot of time even for simple tweaks. If you're lucky, you just have to add a custom package registry or download a tarball. Sometimes, though, you have to write your own clumsy editor script. Although, even these can be worth it. I spent a few minutes writing custom editor scripts for Breezy that have probably ended up saving me hours of menial tasks. Tools can also refer to real hardware. I've gradually increased my gear through Christmas and birthday gifts over the past year. A cheapo wireless mouse with a custom Mondobi mouse pad, a Blue Yeti microphone, a portable MIDI keyboard, and a laptop stand. All these help me make games, music, and videos more easily and efficiently. Hopefully your mind is now brewing with changes you can make to your workflow, but if not, that's okay. Just remember to be conscious about efficiency, as I mentioned. Notice those moments in your daily routine where something can be done faster, or a time-wasting activity can be cut out. If you do all this, you'll unlock more speed and creativity to become a true 10x game dev. Oh, and one last tip. Join my Discord to talk efficiency and everything else. Have a good day. I'm gonna tickle your toes.